Secretaries, rubbish collectors and switchboard operators, just some of the jobs in Australia that are disappearing and fast.
Yeah, census data shows some occupations' employment numbers have dropped by 50% in 5 years. So which jobs could cease to exist in the near future? And our TV hosts on that list.
Is it 5 years?
Social researcher Mark McCrindle joins us with more. Hi, Mark.
Good morning.
Hi, mate.
All right, what professions could be redundant in the next 5 years, given that some have dropped off 50% in the last five?
Yeah, it's a short time frame. Well,
yeah.
Digital photography brought companies down like Kodak, and it's also bringing to an end jobs like photographic processors. Mm. You know, technology brought toll booth collectors to an end, so that's the speed of the change. We now have to do our own typing. Secretaries are disappearing in that sense as the organisations get flatter. We do our own online analysis of products, so we don't need as many sales assistants, and so that retail, particularly from a full-time perspective, doesn't employ as many people as it used to. And textile manufacturing, for reasons other than technology, we're offshoring a lot of the manufacturing roles in Australia for cost reasons, and so that whole manufacturing sector is under great strain.
Is it all about technology? Is that the main cause of a drop in these sorts of jobs?
Technology is a big driver, certainly, but you've also got the cost of labour here versus overseas.
Right, right.
And even areas, accounting, back office operations, actuarial type roles that can be done offshore, database management, that sort of thing, a lot of IT roles are being done offshore. Sure, because of the cheaper labour base.
I've got another list here. Parking inspectors, taxi drivers, mortgage advisors could go the way of the milkman 10 years from now. Why? We're always going to need taxis, aren't we?
Yeah, we are. I think that's a long shot on that one. But we're already starting to see driverless vehicles come around, and that's really the point. I mean, drones from an air perspective, but even a lot of warehouses now done without pickers and machine operators and forklift drivers because it's all automated.
Robotic.
Robotic, eventually. I think because of safety on the roads, it's going to be a fair while before we have driverless vehicles on our roads, but that's the trend.
Well, parking inspectors, who will we abuse? I mean, what's going to happen to parking inspectors?
Technology's bringing that to an end. I mean, now in parking lots, it's all automated, and even streets are going that way. Just like we don't need those toll collectors, there are monitoring systems that can now...
Yeah, that's where you drive over the top and it takes the photo and stuff.
You must live in a fancy area.
I've heard of such things.
I'm still putting the coins in the thing.
If we're looking for work, where should we be heading?
Well, a lot of great opportunities. I mean, even some of the sectors that are on the decline have some growth. So manufacturing overall is declining, but specialist manufacturing, high-tech manufacturing is doing well. Cochlear, ResMed, specialist high-tech manufacturing is creating great opportunities in medical research, for example. We're living longer, we've got an ageing population, and we have an expectation of better quality of life. So medical, the retirement services area is massive. We've got four times as many Australians aged over 85 today as we had in 1984. Massive increase in that age group, so more people than ever there. Good opportunities, it's just watching the demographics and the trends.
And the parcel delivery area.
Yeah.
That's interesting. That was a growth area.
Big parcel growth.
Delivery. Well, that's because of the internet. People buy on
digital
the
economy, but we still need the physical delivery. And so more parcels being sent now than ever. We're sending fewer letters,
but
more parcels.
Does it make sense then that if all of this talk about technology taking over, does it make sense for young people to look towards, or people coming to the end of their time at a workplace, to look towards working in the technology sector because that sounds safest?
Yeah, I think so. It's about upskilling and retraining and ensuring that we're future-proofed with these changes. Not everything has technology as the core, though. I mean, even just demographic growth. We've got a baby boom, so childcare is on the rise.
Yes.
Independent schooling is growing in a big way. Aged care doesn't need technology, but it just needs to analyse where the growth trends are.
And if you can combine a few of those industries, like, say, childcare, put them in the back of the delivery truck, get the kids to throw out the parcels. If you could combine a couple of industries in the one.
Yeah, throw some iPads to
them. You've
got
it made.
What you should do, you should put that down on paper, send it to docks. Because once you get official clearance on that, it'll probably fly. That's a good
cheap
idea.
Labour gives them something to do. You've got your eyes on them. They're in the back.
Yeah. And you can get the people from the aged care facilities to drive them around. So that's good gear.
Well, a solution there.
We've got driverless cars, remember.
That's right.
The plan is coming together.
Run some research on it.
Thank you very much. But TV hosts, they're okay, right?
Very secure. Not going to be automated anytime soon.
Oh, that's what you think. Thank you, mate. We'll talk to you soon.
Thank you, mate. Just ahead, we check out Erica Packer.